Hope you enjoy part number two of Hey Glory to God, how Eve and how to prevent from being bitten by the serpent. That was part number two. Now part number three is Hey Glory to God, Matthew chapter 1-10. And it read, then was Jesus led up of the Spirit unto the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. And when he had fasted 40 days and 40 nights, he was after hungered. And when a tempter came to him, he said, if thou be the Son of God, command that the stone be made bread. But the answer said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceed out of the mouth of God. Then they would take him up in a holy city and set him on a pinnacle of the temple and said to him, if thou be the Son of God, cast thyself from thyself, for it is written, he shall give his angel charge concerning thee, and in their hand they shall bear thee up, lest at any time thou dash thy foot against a stone. Then Jesus said unto him, it is written, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. And again the devil take him up in an exceeding high mountain and show him all the kingdom of the world and the glory of them. This is where people have signed a contract. They become Luciferians. And he said unto them, all these things I give unto thee, if thou wilt fall down and worship me. Then Jesus said unto him, get thee hence, Satan, for it is written, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve. And this is a verse that Satan tricked people in signing contract of your soul. So my message is how to prevent from being bitten by the serpent, part number three. How to prevent from being bitten by the serpent. Now, I don't know where people get the idea that Satan was a serpent in Matthew, the fourth chapter, because it didn't say that. He said he was tempted and the tempter and said the devil, but there's some of movies, it showed that Satan was a serpent into the wilderness with Jesus. So I just followed the commentary and saying that how to prevent from being bitten by the serpent. Now Jesus, hey glory to God, he was wiser than Eve. Hey glory, what did I say? He was wiser than Eve. Because Eve, the five things happened to Eve. Eve communicate, Eve covered, Eve didn't want nothing to do with God. And Eve, glory to God, hallelujah, she got convinced and then she got connected. And the fourth thing, Jesus did four things, hey, glory to God, and it's four W's that Jesus have done. What I say, four W's that Jesus have done in this story. Prove them, preacher. Hey, glory to God, hallelujah. The four things Jesus have done, hey, glory to God, hallelujah. Jesus, my friend, he gave the devil the word. What he did, he gave the devil the word, because the Bible say, and listen, why Jesus was not bitten by the same serpent. Number one, he had the word. Number two, he withstand the temptation. Number three, he worshiped not Satan, but the true God. Let's dig on number one. Sixthly, Jesus had the word. When it say, man shall not live by bread alone, he remembered Deuteronomy, the 8th chapter, verse number 3. What it say? For he humbled you, allow you to be hungry, and fed you with manna, which you did not know, nor did your father know, that he might make you known that man should not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. Amen. You see the part? Hey, glory to God. So that means that, glory to God, that Jesus gave the devil the word. Amen. And the second thing that happened, hey, glory to God, second thing that happened, that Jesus withstand temptation of spiritual suicide by not falling off the pinnacle, the temple. Now, the devil is a scripture twister. He's trying to draw Psalms 9, I think it's what, Psalms, one of those Psalms, hey, glory to, I think it was 91, and he trying to twist the scripture, hey, glory to God, on Jesus. But Jesus Christ, hold on and saying that thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. Glory to God. So how, while Jesus was not tempted like Eve, because Jesus Christ knew the word. And if you are a believer and you're watching this video, my friend, it's time for you to know the word, to stand up against the witches. Amen. To stand up, to give them the word of God. God said, I send forth my word and heal them. So if you are a Christian, to stand to temptation, hey, glory to God, you must have the word of God. Well, I say you must have the word of God. Amen. And the eighth thing he did, he glory to God. Jesus, my friend, he told the devil that you must worship the true God. And the true God is Jesus Christ. He glory to God. So Satan, he glory to God, got nervous. He glory to God because Jesus Christ stood the test. It wasn't like Eve. Eve failed the test. But Jesus Christ passed the test. And the Bible say the devil went away for a season. So he's coming back. And when he come back, make sure you give him the same weapon in the beginning and the same weapon at the end. Amen. Because, my friend, we talking about the mighty God. We talking about the everlasting God. We talking about the powerful God. And the only way you're going to pass your test, your temptation, because it was a temptation, glory to God, even though he say that he was tempted. Listen, when Jesus was led to in the spirit in the wilderness to be tempted of the devil give temptation and God give tests. God give tests to elevate you, and the devil give a temptation for you to fall into sin and snare. And I'm telling you, you ain't got to prove nothing to nobody. Prove that you are Christian. Prove that you can walk on water. Prove that you can drink poison. Prove that you can, and the deadly thing shall not harm you. You ain't got to prove nothing to nobody. What I say, you ain't got to prove nothing to nobody. Because what? Why, preacher? Because, my friend, you are, glory to God, you know what you are. You ain't got to prove nothing to the devil. And that's why the guy that's out of Africa, when a young lady say, prove that you're a man of God, and it was a script. It's a script that he remembered everything that she told, that she told the man of God. Amen. He told the fake pastor that's in South Africa, the billionaire pastor. Hey, glory to God. You ain't got to prove nothing to nobody. Don't prove nothing to nobody. If you prove something, because Jesus Christ didn't turn a stone into bread. Jesus Christ didn't go on a pinnacle and cast himself from down. Jesus Christ didn't fall by the power of Satan by giving the world. Why would Satan give Jesus Christ the world? Because the world belonged to Jesus. Because the Bible says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word with God, Word was God. Same beginning with God. All things were made by him. By who? By Jesus. So Jesus, he's trying to give Jesus what already belonged to him. So why Jesus was not bitten? Because Jesus knew the word. Jesus Christ withstood the word, and Jesus Christ withstood temptation, and Jesus Christ didn't fall down and worship the devil when the devil offered Jesus Christ the world. That's the only way you're going to stand. You're going to stand by you knowing the word of God. If you don't know the word of God, you can't shout your way out of this. You got to know your word. The Bible said, the word if I hid in my heart, then I may sin against thee. The only way you're going to stand, temptation comes, my friend, you got to stand on the word of God. You got to know the word of God deep down in your sanctified soul. Don't let nobody fool you. You got to study the word of God. Be like the church of Berea. They study the word of God to see what a Paul. It ain't talking about reading. It's talking about studying. There's a difference between studying and reading. You read it, but you don't believe it. You don't live it. Hey, glory to God. But when you study it, it's like a marinade. Meditation means study. Meditate don't mean yoga. Yoga is evil. Yoga is empty. I don't believe in no breath exercise. It's nothing but demonic. It's Hindu. Yoga is Hindu. And if you are doing yoga, my friend, stop it. Because you're going to fall into the snare of the devil, emptying your mind. The Bible said, let this mind be in you, which was in Christ Jesus. So if you are doing yoga, my friend, yoga is demonic. Hey, what I say? Yoga is demonic. We ought to study the word of God. We ought to meditate in it day and night. Meditate don't mean yoga. It don't mean you get into a yoga stand and doing, no, my friend. You meditate by studying the word of God, line upon line, priest by priest. And that was Eve. Eve should not communicate with the devil, communicate with the serpent. That's why she fell. That's why she covered after the tree and the fruit and picked it and gave it to her husband. And if you're watching the video, my friend, the only way you stand, the only way you go to, if you're dealing with lust, if you're dealing with sex, if you're dealing with addiction, if you're dealing with pornography, my friend, you got to withstand the temptation. If it comes, get on your knees, say, Lord, help me. Be like Joseph, run out the house. Don't. The Bible says he'd make a way for your escape so you can bear it. You got to bear the temptation. Amen. Well, I say, bear the temptation and God will help you to withstand the temptation. Amen. A lot of people been bitten, my friend. They've been bitten. Why? Because they don't have no word. When somebody say, have sex with me, you ain't got no word to say no. I'm waiting to get married. Come on. If somebody say drink, I say, no, I get some juice. Somebody say, smoke the weed. Say, no, why should I smoke the weed? Why should it destroy my lung? Amen. You gotta have the word and stand on the word of God. Don't settle for less. Settle for the great test. Settle because you want to go to heaven. You don't want to go to hell. And that's what happened with Eve. Eve got kicked out of the garden. Amen. If you are a Christian and you're watching this video, my friend, stand on the word of God. You need the word of God. Don't let nobody fool you. The reason why people are bitten by witchcraft, because they don't have no word in them. They left the church because they have no word in them. They leave God because they have no word in them. If you had the word of God, my friend, you wouldn't leave God. You're empty, and the devil fill you up. That's why you got to be sold out for Jesus. I have no room for the devil, because my cup runs over. Surely goodness shall follow me all the days of my life. So why Jesus was not bitten by the serpent? Because Jesus stood the test. He had the word, it would stand, and he worshiped the true God.